Full of tartan and bagpipes, the new Dunedin exhibition explores Scottish heritage in the Deep South. The exhibition will open to the public tomorrow, with the Toitū Otago Settlers Museum hoping all those with Scottish ancestry will come and share their thoughts. Dunedin has been seen by many as a predominant Scottish town, and curator Sean Brosnahan wants to see if this is still a fair reflection.
This exhibition is a reflection on Dunedin and its Scottish heritage. You know, this is the first exhibition, our temporary exhibition space since the museum reopened, so we thought it was really appropriate that we start at the beginning of what Dunedin was about, which was a Scottish colony for Scots, for Presbyterian Scots. And yet today, you know, over 160 years later, how much is that heritage still alive?
The exhibition features displays, many donated from within Dunedin. The public will also have the chance to vote on a referendum to give their thoughts on if Scotland should be politically independent. Along with this, the museum will also engage with the public and try and get them to ask themselves questions about their ancestry.
Is it meaningful to what you do in terms of Scottish practices? You know, I mean, are you still a Presbyterian? Maybe not. Are you still going to go and support Burns night suppers? Do you still go and watch pipe bands? Or if you hear the pipes, does it stir your blood? Do you wear a tartan? Do you identify with a clan? Those sorts of things. Those are questions that are open, and we're interested just to see how that all plays out in the next future period.
The exhibition will run until July, giving people plenty of time to share their thoughts and decide if Dunedin is still the Edinburgh of the South 160 years on. John McKenzie, 39, Dunedin News.